It's rubbish. Synthetic rubbish. I think that there's still some outdated laws in regards to wormwood being inside Abathon, so... And back to the drop frame count, we've got 9,697 drop frames, or 4.3% of the stream. Very disheartening. Does that include video games, for example, Manhunt? I'm not quite sure about, I do know for a fact that certain games are banned, in Australia, and also a lot of games, are censored in Australia. But, you know, it's the internet. If we want, if it's a digital item, which, you know, software is, then we can just, you know, torrent it or, What's the other method other than torrenting? Torrenting's still the big one, isn't it? But there's also like file dump areas, like, you know, like a mega, or well, I don't wanna put too many names out there, but there are websites, let's just say, where you can get games. So for example, in I think Hotline Miami, I believe, is censored or banned in Australia. However, I bought it before the ban was put in place, so I still have Hotline Miami 1 and 2, which I still haven't played. I've seen Hotline Miami play before, you know, and it's uncensored from what I can tell. ROMs and ISOs, yep. I mean, I'm all about the pirate life. I mean, not that I pirate much now, because I've accumulated so much, I would never get through it all in my lifetime. I'm not really big into movies and TV shows now. In my opinion, a lot of them are all garbo. Not all of them are garbo. Like, I'm still looking forward to season 3 of The Boys. I'm looking forward to that one, but I mean, there's not a lot of movies coming out that I want to watch at all. Arrgh! Indeed. Like, I mean, a lot of corporations, have folded now. Like, old Sega, they folded. They're around now, but I don't think they're the same sort of thing. It's the same with Atari. So, a lot of their old intellectual property, I guess someone still owns, but... It's not like they're gonna chase you down for playing, like, old pirated Atari ROMs. Or Commodore 64 ROMs. Yeah. Anyway. Okay. Still time for redemption? I think this guy, you know... Hopefully you also include a self-destruct. I mean, this is interesting information. Sure. Yeah. Is he gonna give it up? Is he gonna give us the information? Landline. Hell yeah. Nice. Sorry, the Twitch app crashed. Oh. You mean, am I streaming right now, though? Let me just check. Okay, I'm gonna hold up my hand. Yeah. Okay, so... Yeah. For me, not you. Your stream was fine. Well, I would dispute that. It's been going up and down. The bitrate has been going crazy today. It could be because I'm using a VPN. But, you know, I'm unsure. But, okay, good. It's good that, you know, I'm still streaming. I advise you to stop talking. Yeah, Kara. I got a lot of information out of this fool. Diana. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, I don't like the idea of, like, super optimization either. It sounds implausible and taxing. Okay, imagine like isn't there a statistic like saying we only use like 15 to 20% of our brain while conscious? So imagine like what they're talking about is like, oh, we're gonna like make it super optimal, like you'll use 70 to 80% of your brain. And like, yeah, that sounds great, except, like, in reality, they'll probably, like, kill you early, wouldn't it? Like, there's probably a natural reason why we only, like, utilize 15 to 20% of our brain. That's the way that I look at it. So when we're unconscious, does that mean we use more of our brain? I think it's like, I think we rest parts of our brain and then it kind of shifts over. Yeah, but imagine like if we were using all parts of it at all times, wouldn't that stress out the brain? Like if the statistic is true, like 15 to 20%, and they bumped it to something like 30, that could be interesting. I still think it would be probably a bit unethical. They'd still probably do it anyway because scientists are gonna science. Like, for the benefit of humanity, you know? To make an omelet, you gotta break a few eggs, right? Not like they give a fuck. I don't know, to be 100% honest, there is, for example, the ones brought up in Lucy. Ah, right. Yeah, the one with ScarJo. A lot of weird stuff going on in that particular movie, though. Yeah. Wasn't there also another one with Bradley Cooper? Like, Unlimited? Man, I haven't watched movies for so long. It's like, almost like when the pandemic hit. Like, beginning of 2020, it was just like, I'm not really interested in watching movies. I'm like, eh. I mean, of course, the old stuff, the old gold is still good. Like, you know, just off the top of my head, I've watched The Terminator, Flash Gordon, what was another one? Running Man. Love Arnold Schwarzenegger movies. They're so good. Yeah, but nothing lately. Nothing lately. Anyway, back to the game. Back to video game. Yeah, if they gave people like the option to augment their brain to be more efficient, like with anything in life, I would probably just say, okay, I'm gonna see how this pans out. I'm gonna watch what happens for a few years before you take the plunge. It's like people with the that LASIK surgery. If I were eligible for LASIK, I still wouldn't take it. I don't trust it. I mean, yeah, but it's all played for fun. In fact, I'd love to see ScarJo in a Resident Evil style movie. I mean, they've done so many Resident Evil movies though, with Mila Jokovic. Djokovic? Yeah. Like, how many movies are out there, Resident Evil movies? Like, 7 or 8? And that's not including the Japanese, like, CGI ones as well. I think with ScarJo, like, she's a very recognizable name, but she's getting up there in years. The roles that we would like her to have been in, she's kind of past it. She's not like an athletic 20-something anymore. She's pushing 40. I think Black Widow was the last one of those sorts of movies for her. We'll see her transition into different roles, I think. She's been on the camera for such a long time. Like, I think she got into movies in her late teens, I want to say. Or even early teens, I can't quite recall. ScarJo has grown up in front of our very eyes. In public. This is brainwashing. Yeah, I always forget she's in her 40s. Yep. Yep. Been around, she's still beautiful. No, she's still a beautiful woman, it's just... Father Time is undefeated. It's not that extreme, why are you staring against it? Why do you think you have the right to play God? No. This will end human evolution? No, it will probably kickstart. Let people be depressed. I think so. Like, what right do you have to, like, decide how people feel? Which is what the end goal for this project seems to be. Human evolution. Would it end human evolution? I think that that's a very, like, what do you call that? Like a loaded statement? It's very loaded. I like the second one. Oh, because it's all about being productive. Yeah, if you're not hyper-productive, you're not truly living. Right. I'm impressed people like Tom Cruise can do action movies at his age. We need actresses like him. But you could also argue that actors like Tom Cruise, ScarJo, they've earned their millions. They've earned their fame, like, and they've accumulated enough of it. At what point do you say to them, thank you very much, but we're interested in the new crop of actors? So if like the top tier is like constantly like it just has actors like Tom Cruise, Tom Hanks, ScarJo, Leo DiCaprio, Denzel Washington, and they never fully go away. If they just dominate headlines permanently, I think it leads to a kind of stagnation.